Your life will never be the same.
Don't you know your life will turn around?
Resurrection power is here.
Beloved, welcome to another exciting morning on The Voice of Resurrection. We are learning the mystery behind the breastplate of righteousness. There's so many exciting things we will learn. But first of all, we want to understand righteousness itself before we can wear it. Before we can wear it. One of our biggest struggles in Christendom is self-righteousness that comes from religion. As soon as God begins to deliver us from things, we begin to feel personal justification. We lose understanding of righteousness. That's why believers fall into a ditch when things go astray or go haywire in their lives, and they feel like, well, why should this happen? I haven't done this, I haven't done that, I've been this and I've been that. Beloved, none of that means anything. What matters is that your only position before God is given to you based on Jesus' obedience, his righteousness with God bought it for you. Listen carefully. Obedience will lead to blessings, but obedience does not earn you the right before God. The right before God was given, and you can never earn it. And God said he put it that way that no flesh will ever glory in his presence. There's nothing you can do in this life, even if you've never sinned one time for all your life on the earth, beloved, even though that's not possible. That even if you could produce that, you will still be rejected before God. Until you get that, you will not begin your journey of faith before God. The release of God's grace will always be hindered in your life. There is nothing you can ever do to earn your place before God. It has to be that the only reason God accepts you is because of Jesus. It gets you completely out of it. I'm not encouraging you to sin, but I'm telling you, if unfortunately you sin, that's how you are able to get out of it and return to God in faith and begin the journey of reconstruction and making corrections and then doing whatever God tells you to do to solve it. And you will not live in condemnation. It also saves you that after you've worked out your issues and now you're flowing in holiness and in righteousness and God is blessing and everything is going great, you never get in pride either. So it saves you from both ends. You have to understand this before you can wear a breastplate. Otherwise, Satan will be trafficking in and out of your life. I can see that it will be by the second or third week before I get to the actual breastplate. But this foundation must be established. Most believers don't have it. We know it mentally. But in reality, we are religious. In reality, when we are obedient to God, our faith is up. When we are struggling, our faith, there is no faith whatsoever. That's why we are very judgmental and critical about other people. We don't know how to believe God with people so they can overcome their weaknesses. They can overcome their flaws. We begin to think that God accepts and rejects based on performance. No, he only accepts by the blood of Jesus. And then I will get to the power of faith in this. It is so fascinating. It will change your life once you understand it. It will deliver you and give you the ability to get up and kick the devil out of your life in Jesus' mighty name. Let's read the text once again in Romans chapter 5. I read again verse 18. Therefore, as by the offense of one, judgment came upon all men to condemnation. Pay attention to it. You popped out of the womb a sinner. Wow. The moment you came out, boom, you're a sinner. Why? Adam sinned. Don't you see? You were born into it. You popped out one. There's no way you can fix it on your own. Absolutely not. What believers confuse is holiness with righteousness. holiness is allowing God to purge you of sins so that your condition begins to match your position. But you can never earn your place in the presence of God. You can never. You will always stay in pride on both ends. Whether if you're right, you're in pride. If you're wrong, you're in pride. Until you receive, understand and receive righteousness, that's the day your true salvation begins. Listen carefully. Therefore, as by the offense of one, judgment came upon all men to condemnation. Even so, by the righteousness of one, listen carefully, the free gift, beloved, it's a gift. You can never earn it. It's a gift. The free gift came upon, listen to this, all men unto justification. And do you understand what justification means? Like you've never sinned. God relates to you like you've never sinned. He just forgives the moment you ask. You are brought into the kingdom and given a brand new slate. And now whatever happens is what you do after that. But for you to come in the door, you can never earn it. Hallelujah. It says, the free gift came upon all men unto justification of life. For as by one man's disobedience many were made sinners, so by the obedience of one shall many be made righteous. In other words, again, I am made righteous because of the obedience of Jesus Christ to the Father. I am not righteous because I didn't lie or I didn't commit fornication or I didn't cheat. I'm not righteous because of that. That's issues of holiness. Righteousness is Jesus' obedience to the Father giving me a place to even begin to talk about what to correct and what not to correct. God put it this way to the nation of Israel. He said, your righteousness are like filthy rags in my presence. You must come by the blood. We love you. Let's continue tomorrow. Let's check it. Bye.
The Lord is waiting on you.